We are in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning with one of our favorite guys, Nick Rabar from Avenue N in Rumford. We're making barbecue braised beef short rib stuffed burgers.
That's a mouthful.
That is a mouthful.
And it literally will be in the end.
Yeah, wow, that is a mouthful. And it looks, you know, I mean, everything that we have here looks fantastic. And you're telling me off the air that most of the ingredients that we have for this recipe are from local, you know,
from local, yes. Right. I mean, we have our bread here from our friends down at Olga's, our cheese here from our friends at Farmstead. We have beekeeper's honey that we get right from Rumford, right from our own backyard.
You were saying this lady gives up her life to get this honey for you.
She's willing to get stung for the good of all natural. Local,
right,
so.
Right.
but you know what? Burgers are just the ultimate comfort food.
Right.
And so today, we'll not only talk about tips to making a great burger, mm-hmm. we'll also show you this burger that is like some like steroidic giant mega burger.
This isn't, yeah, I was going to say, this isn't just, you know, your, the burger you cook in your backyard on the grill.
No.
This is the ultimate, the ultimate meat lover burger.
It's the ultimate. We have braised short rib.
Okay.
Which is just a fantastic cut. I've been braising it since about 4 o'clock in the morning. So it's about a 5 hour long braise.
Oh, really?
And some of the spices that we have in there are barbecue oriented. So there's a touch of molasses, there's a touch of Worcestershire, some brown sugar, some ketchup, and then all of the all-natural stuff that goes into it, like the mirepoix, like the onions, the carrots, the celery, etc.
Right.
And then what we're going to do is pull that apart, and we're going to stuff it inside a burger. Now, if you don't want to stuff it inside a burger, this recipe is good to go. Put it over mashed potatoes, put it over grits.
Did you see the smile on my face?
I see it. I see it. I was trying to talk through it.
Okay, perfect, Nick. We are going to keep braising. We're getting our ingredients together. In the meantime, back to you.
All right, that's right. We are cooking with Chef Nick Rabar from Avenue N making.
We're making barbecue braised short rib stuffed burgers.
Did you get all that?
It's a lot.
Hope you had a pen and pencil.
It's a lot. And, you know, to top that off, we're going to make our own ketchup and our own mayonnaise today.
Oh, yum.
But we're going to call them compote and aioli. Okay, so now what I've done here, I've taken some tomatoes and some shallots and sort of stewed them down.
Okay.
All right, and this is going to be our ketchup.
Okay.
So over here, Michaela, I have some balsamic vinegar. You can go in with that.
How much balsamic?
All of it. Go in with all of it.
Well, how much is in there?
That's about 2 tablespoons.
Oh, okay.
And then I have this fig jam that I made. So it's all natural. There's no high fructose syrup in there. There's no corn syrup or anything like that.
Okay.
So this is all natural fig jam. So that's going in there also.
Where can you find this?
Well, you can either make it or you can find it, I think, pretty much anywhere. I mean, it's in grocery stores. You know, just hit the jam aisle. They don't. And see, this is a nice dark one because I add a little bit of cocoa to it also.
Okay.
All right.
And then
you can go in with just a touch of that.
See, what is this?
That's just a little fresh basil.
Okay.
All right. And then I'm going to have you just whisk this up.
Right.
And while you do that, I'm going to stuff these burgers. Okay, so tips for buying good burger.
Yep.
Look for 80-20, which means 80% lean meat, 20% fat.
Okay.
And
does it say that on the package?
It will say it on the package.
Just checking.
And if you go to a butcher, for it, ask them for a coarse grind, because that makes for a better burger.
Okay.
And I have this short rib here. All right, this is what it looked like raw.
Yep.
So this was what it looked like about 5 hours ago. Great muscular fat right there, that's called marbling,
mm-hmm.
and that's going to add a ton of flavor and keep it nice and tender.
Okay.
And this is what it looks like 5 hours later, and you can see how it just sort of flakes right off.
Wow. So
very,
we're
going to
stuff
tender.
Our burger.
We're
going to
stuff
that.
It with that. So this is it here.
Okay.
And all the barbecue spices were right in that stew right there.
All right. Well, we're going to keep stuffing this burger with a whole lot of other things and cook it up at the end of the show. But for now, back to you. All right, barbecue braised beef short rib stuffed burgers are on the menu in the kitchen this morning. Chef Nick Rabar from Avenue N joins us. That is a mouthful.
Oh, it is. That's a big that's a big name for it.
But it's worth it. It's worth every second of it.
Okay.
So now, after we stuffed it, we formed it, we pinched the edges, we're searing it.
Okay?
Just a touch of olive oil. You want high heat. Now, I always sear burgers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a big fan, all right, as opposed to grilling.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't add any of that charcoal flavor, but to me, that's a good thing.
Okay.
Because I don't want it with all the stuff that we're sort of adding in here today.
Right?
Yeah. And this is searing away right now. You're going to need about 5 minutes on the first side.
Okay.
You want to get a nice char in it. While that's happening, we're going to make a little aioli.
All right.
Okay, so basically we're making our own mayonnaise. So, I'm going to start you off here with some pasteurized egg yolks.
And like you said, you know, we're going to have to pour this in pretty slow, too.
Yeah, you want to go slow, because if you go too fast, it's going to break. So hold on to the bowl there, Will. Get a good grip on it.
How many egg yolks?
And start whisking away. That's about 3 egg yolks.
Three egg
yolks, and I've got about a half cup of olive oil here.
Mm-hmm.
And then about a cup of canola oil.
Okay.
Now,
there's a lot
to make
going
this, oh yeah, to make this emulsify, which means sort of just bring it together, because remember, you're trying to sustain liquid and fat, and they're, you know, you pour them into a cup, they're going to look very, very different.
Separate.
I'm going to add a touch of vinegar. So mayonnaise is very simple to make.
Can you use any kind of vinegar? Because I know there's red wine, there's apple cider.
You can.
It'll give it a different flavor.
And even more so, you can use less fatty oils, too, if you want. So you can make it a lighter.
But at this point,
no. Listen, we're stuffed.
Well,
we're stuffing meat with meat here, Will. You think we're worried about our health?
Yeah, not at this point.
So, but it is really, really delicious. And I mean, and a lot of this stuff, is since it's all natural, you know, it's, you know, well-grown, well-taken care of. It's actually not that bad for you.
So much better than that tub of mayonnaise that's sitting in there.
So much. While you're doing that there, Will, we're going to go in with that other oil right there, that canola oil.
Okay.
And I've got that compote that we made.
Now that's right. Am I pouring the whole thing in there?
Go right in.
All right, I'll pour that in. I'll keep whisking.
I've got that great compote.
Okay.
And Mikhail, I'm going to ask you to hand me that bun. I've got that top one there that I pre-sliced.
Oh, yeah.
All right, and I seared it so it's nice and brown in there.
Wow.
I seared it with a little bit of clarified butter. All right. Give it a nice flip. And we're starting to caramelize off very well. So, I'm going to switch spots with you there, little lady.
Okay.
And I'm going to start to build this up. So, we've got this plate here.
I'll keep an eye on this burger.
I'm just whisking.
Whisk away over there, Will. Whisk away. Add a little salt in there. And then there's garlic down there also I want you to put in there. All authentic aiolis have garlic. It's you know, it comes from Spain, and it's a very well-known sauce. So, it's very well-respected. And that little garlic adds a little bit of pungency.
It smells great.
It looks great. So, I've got this bib lettuce here.
Bib lettuce?
Bib lettuce. All right. It's very beautiful. And you can see it's still on the root. So it's very, very fresh. We're going to put that down.
I like that. I feel like it holds together better, too, than an iceberg or something. It just looks...
And, you know, the iceberg, you know, can sometimes make the burger sort of teeter off.
Yeah.
Now, a great tip for onions for a burger so you don't have that raw onion flavor in your mouth is to grill them. That releases some of the sugar, makes it a little bit sweeter.
See, I'm one of those people, too. I won't eat the raw onion,
but you like it when it's cooked.
Well, it makes a big difference. It releases all that natural sugars. Yeah. Makes it very, very sweet. And if you buy a sweet onion, too, like a Vidalia onion, or just, you'll see them in the market, just sweet onions. Sometimes they come from Peru or just other parts of Georgia. That'll go a long way also.
Oh, okay.
So now we've got our burger here.
Yeah.
It's probably about medium rare.
Okay.
I'm going to pull it.
Perfect.
Okay. And I'm going to top it with some of this, what's called Grayson cheese, okay? This Grayson cheese is very pungent. It's from my friend Matt at Farmstead in Wayland Square.
If you were to compare this to another, maybe more well-known cheese, what does it taste like?
Well, I'm going to tell you, it's kind of a cross between, it has the texture of a brie and the flavor of a fontina. So it's a hearty, hearty
I love cheese.
And it can hold up to this burger very, very well.
I guess
Will, I'm going to ask you to just put a little bit of that beautiful aioli right on top of this bun here.
Okay.
And while you do that, I'm going to top it with this compote.
There we go.
Nice. I like that on the finger.
So a little bit of that compote, which is going to play the part of our ketchup today. And you just have a little bit of that aioli there. And bang.
Wow. Wait.
That's our burger.
Whoa.
All right. And put a couple of sticks in it just to hold it together because it's going to need that.
Yeah, I don't even know if I can fit the...
Well, you're going to have to find a way.
Can you unlock your jaw like a snake?
You're
going
to have to find a way. It is a beaut. I mean, so, you know, you got, of course, the homemade fries.
Yeah.
So all hand cut. Let's give it a cut here.
Yeah, I think that would be
I think you're just going to have to handle it.
Let's give it a quick... Oh, you want me to just go?
I want to see what you're made of. That's what I want to see.
Go.
Now, be careful. It's going to drip.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah, girl. That is an aggressive bite.
And if you want this recipe, head to our website right now, WBRI.com.